If z is any complex number and I take its modulus, when I write this kind of inequality, I am implying that the modulus of z is a real number and it's not negative. It's greater than or equal to zero. Why? We'll just take a look at the equation. Notice there's no I in this equation. I'm taking the real and imaginary parts separately as real numbers, squaring them each individually, adding the results, and taking the square root of that. X squared plus y squared, no matter whether x and y are positive or negative, is a quantity that's greater than or equal to zero. And you take the square root of such a quantity, you get a quantity greater than or equal to zero. Moreover, also, the only way you're going to get a modulus equal to zero, the only way the modulus of z is zero is if z itself is the number zero, which I can think of as a complex number, zero plus zero I. Think about that. The only way this quantity is ever going to be zero is if both x and y are zero. No other time.